when there's a guy parked outside my house that I can't deny. You know what I mean? Like it was fun. So I'm just wondering how much, like, do you feel almost schizophrenic because you're paranoid on one hand? On the other hand, you must be jacked with adrenaline.
Totally. That's why you go into journalism, right? Is to do stories like this. And I mean, of course, like, you know, you have to enjoy those moments, right? Those are the moments in life that ultimately shape who you are and what you leave for the world. And if you obsess on the dangers, you become paralyzed with fear. And you have to kind of find the humor in it. You know, and it was kind of amazing that we were in Hong Kong, you know, a city that has absolutely no connection to the U.S. security state. And we were publishing stories. They had no idea where we were, that were shaking the world. They were, you know, like severing diplomatic relations between countries. And that was impossible for me to sleep, you know, even with narcotics. I would take like the strongest, you know, tranquilizers or like sleeping pills in the world. And I still was sleeping 90 minutes. Cause like, why the fuck would I sleep? I had like I wanted to keep publishing documents and like keep the NSA just like on their heels, scared and unable to get off the canvas and start to counterattack. Plus, like, it was, you know, I had been writing about the NSA for years. I had been warning that the NSA was spying on the internet and engaging in surveillance far more broadly and invasively than the law permitted or that we knew. But it was so difficult to prove that because of how opaque they are. And finally, in my hands, I had all the proof.